For the United States Marine Corps, amphibious ships are far more than mere vessels. They are the lifeblood of the Corps' mission, ethos, and operational effectiveness. These ships embody the Marines' identity as an expeditionary force in readiness, always prepared to fight and win battles on foreign shores or provide aid in the face of disasters. Amphibious ships serve as both platforms for projection and symbols of the Corps' unwavering commitment to adaptability and rapid response. Even though the origins of U.S. amphibious operations trace back to the Revolutionary War and the early 19th century, the Navy's role was limited to transport and blockade, and there was no dedicated amphibious fleet. The advent of World War II underscored the need for specialized amphibious ships capable of supporting large-scale operations. The U.S. Navy developed an array of ship types to meet the demands of global amphibious warfare like landing ship, tank, landing craft, infantry and landing craft, vehicle, personnel and attack transport. Notable World War II operations including Operation Overlord in Normandy, Operation Torch in North Africa, and the island assaults on Iwo Jima and Okinawa demonstrated the strategic value of amphibious ships in achieving victory. The Cold War brought a shift in naval strategy, with amphibious ships adapting to the evolving geopolitical climate and technological advancements. Dock landing ships became more sophisticated during the Cold War. These ships featured well decks for carrying landing craft and amphibious vehicles, enabling more efficient ship-to-shore operations. The 1950s saw the development of helicopter carriers like the USS Iwo Jima, which introduced the ability to deploy troops and equipment via helicopters. This marked the beginning of vertical envelopment tactics. The Raleigh class and later the Austin class introduced the concept of combining troop transport and landing craft deployment in a single hull, reflecting a move toward multi-mission capability. Cold War amphibious ships played a crucial role in conflicts such as the Korean War and the Vietnam War, where they supported landings and provided offshore staging for helicopters and logistical support. The end of the Cold War shifted focus toward regional conflicts, humanitarian assistance, and peacekeeping missions. Amphibious ships became increasingly modular and expeditionary. Introduced in the late 1980s, WASP-class amphibious assault ships combined the capabilities of a helicopter carrier and a well deck. They were designed to carry AV-8B Harriers and later the F-35B Lightning II, along with amphibious vehicles and helicopters. The San Antonio-class amphibious transport dock represents a major evolution in the United States Navy's amphibious warfare capabilities. Introduced in the early 21st century, the class was designed to replace aging vessels while meeting the demands of more expeditionary warfare, technological advancements, and evolving geopolitical realities. The decision to build the San Antonio class was the result of a combination of operational needs, strategic priorities, and lessons learned from previous ship classes. Embarking on a journey across the world's oceans, the San Antonio-class ships are a testament to American naval might, with 11 vessels already in service and two more poised to join. The USS New York, a key member of this fleet, carries a unique legacy. Its very frame includes steel from the World Trade Center. This meaningful incorporation, though only 7.5 short tons, transforms the ship into a floating monument, a powerful reminder of resilience and the enduring spirit of unity that emerged from one of the nation's darkest hours. The San Antonio class represents a key element of the United States Navy's ability to project power and maintain a global presence. Towering over churning waves, the San Antonio-class amphibious transport dock isn't just a colossal ship, it's a force multiplier, a logistical powerhouse, and a symbol of American maritime might. These advanced warships are a testament to modern naval engineering, combining vast capacity and advanced technology. In terms of size and displacement, the San Antonio-class LPDs are impressive. Each ship spans approximately 684 feet in length, with a beam of 105 feet, making them sizable platforms for a wide array of missions. They displace roughly 25,000 tons when fully loaded, which is indicative of their substantial carrying capacity and the robustness of their design. The sheer size of these vessels allows them to conduct complex operations, ranging from amphibious assaults to humanitarian aid. That's San Antonio in all its glory, carving through the ocean at a respectable 21 knots, its 105-foot beam leaving the wake as wide as a city street. This speed is facilitated by four turbocharged diesel engines, which drive two shafts. The range of these ships is equally impressive, capable of covering approximately 9,500 nautical miles at a cruising speed of 18 knots. This allows them to deploy and sustain operations across the globe without the constant need for resupply. Its heart beats with a potent dual rhythm. Two LM2500+ gas turbines roar alongside two Colt Pieltstick diesel engines, churning the sea and propelling this behemoth across the globe. But the San Antonio is much more than just engines and steel. One of the primary driving factors behind the development of the San Antonio class was the Navy's need for a versatile platform capable of performing multiple roles in modern operations. The flight deck is capable of handling a variety of aircraft, including the MV-22 Osprey tilt-rotor aircraft, CH-53E Super Stallion helicopters, and UH-1Y Venom helicopters, which further extend the ship's reach and capabilities. The internal configuration of these ships is designed for versatility and efficiency. They can carry up to 800 Marines, along with their associated equipment, vehicles, and supplies. The expansive 676-foot well deck of a San Antonio-class LPD can accommodate landing craft such as the LCAC, or landing craft air cushion, or traditional landing craft to facilitate the movement of troops and equipment to shore. Below decks, almost 20,000 square feet of cargo space swallow supplies and equipment, ensuring logistical support for even the most extended missions. The class is fitted with the integrated ship self-defense system. The system fuses the radars and other sensors and controls the weapons systems for an automated fast reaction capability against air threats. Two Mark 46 30mm guns and a bristling array of 50 caliber machine guns stand guard, while rolling airframe missile launchers and electronic warfare countermeasures provide a layered defense against aerial threats. Beyond the impressive features lies the true strength of the San Antonio, its versatility. It can morph from a war machine into a humanitarian haven within hours, its well deck becoming a launch pad for aid deliveries instead of amphibious assaults. This adaptability makes it an invaluable asset in the ever-changing landscape of modern warfare and international crises. The vessels are equipped to serve as retrieval ships for space capsules, featuring a well deck at the rear that can be flooded, allowing a capsule to be floated into it. Notably, the USS Portland played its role in the Orion capsule from the unmanned Artemis 1 mission that orbited the moon, successfully recovering it on December 11, 2022. The San Antonio class aligns with the Navy and Marine Corps' focus on expeditionary warfare and the ability to project power from the sea. These ships form a critical part of the Amphibious Ready Group and Marine Expeditionary Unit constructs, which allow rapid response to crises around the globe. Expeditionary warfare requires platforms that can operate independently or as part of larger strike groups, delivering Marines and their equipment to contested or austere environments. The San Antonio class's advanced capabilities ensure it can fulfill this role in both high-intensity conflict and low-intensity operations. The post-Cold War world presented new challenges, including regional conflicts, terrorism, and humanitarian crises. The Navy needed ships capable of projecting power and responding to crises in a variety of environments. The San Antonio class are optimized for operations in shallow waters, enabling the Navy to conduct missions close to enemy shores or disaster-stricken areas. The ability to deploy and sustain forces worldwide is a cornerstone of U.S. military strategy. The San Antonio class contributes to this by supporting forward-deployed forces and rapid response capabilities. The San Antonio class fits into the broader framework of the Navy's modernization efforts. As the Navy moves toward distributed maritime operations and expeditionary advanced base operations, the class provides the flexibility and capability to support these doctrines. Its design also serves as a baseline for future ship development, with lessons learned influencing subsequent classes like the light amphibious warship and other next-generation platforms. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into San Antonio-class amphibious ships. So, what do you think about these remarkable war vessels? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to see one of the ships mentioned in this video up close, or better yet, served in one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.